issues, nothing, you know. What do you think you should talk to a guy about? What should you, what conversation should you have with a person like that? What do you think I asked that guy? What would you ask? It's a good
business. What are you doing with the money that you make from the business? Like, how are you investing that and securing your, like, your retirement?
He's set for life.
Would you consider selling the business via seller financing?
Oh, keep going, Brent. Thank you. Keep going.
Yeah. Like, have you considered an offer or selling your company ever and still receiving payments from it and not having to deal with this anymore and drive the limo?
That's exactly what I said. Well, why don't you, here it is, by the way, Pinehurst Taxi. Okay. Really nice cars and drivers and everything, you know, and it's for, you know, it's for people who don't want to take an Uber or a taxi or rent a car. I just like to get out of the airport. There's a limo waiting for me, takes me right to the doorstep. Good driver. Oh, you know, nice people. They either don't talk to you or they do talk, depending on if you're working or not. It's a nice, big, clean car with a safe driver. So I did exactly what Brent said. I said, you know, have you ever considered selling it? And he said, well, I did try to sell it. I used a broker and everything like that. And the person was worthless. They didn't do a darn thing. And I said, well, you know, I talk to a lot of people on Monday, and I do a recording, and I talk to a lot of people from all over the U.S. and I do a recording, and suppose I could find a buyer for you. What could we work out? Guess what he said? Come on, Richard.
That would be awesome, Claude.
He said, yeah, that'd be great. He sent me all this information about the cars, about the income, the spreadsheet, the whole nine yards. Okay. I know I could make at least something like 10 to 15% commission easily on this by just providing him with another buyer or an investor. So does anybody here want a ready-made limousine business? I've got one for you with drivers, cars, and everything. Makes $350,000 to $400,000 a year. I mean, are there opportunity? Here's the thing. Here's my point. I'm not trying to sell you guys a limousine company, but are there opportunities when you talk to people, buyers, sellers, people who have businesses already? You know, can it hurt to ask? You just never know, right? You just never know. So now in the back of my head, I'm talking to a few people about, hey, would you like to move to North Carolina? Would you like to have a ready-made business? And I go into my database and I sort it for North Carolina and Virginia and the aligning states. Maybe somebody will buy it from the guy. Maybe I'll get free limo service for life. I don't know. Is there the same opportunities in real estate? But I always think the problem is we need to ask more. We need to talk to people. We need to make offers right away. Hey, imagine for a moment, I wanted to buy your house, or I could find somebody who wanted to buy your house. Or would you consider doing financing for your business if I could find somebody with a substantial down payment? Yeah, we could do that. Boom. Do you think a 78-year-old guy wants to retire and just get a check every month?